Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world of Wayne, and things are getting serious now. We have got the next four stages of the Fanhome release of Build Your Own R2-D2. Now what do I mean they're getting serious? Well, we're actually starting to put the electrics in. We're going to start fitting the panels onto the dome as well, which means, finally, what I've been saying since stage one of this, I am going to start using my metal little hex screws here. Now these are in the video description. They're also in my Amazon store. You can check them out. And if you don't want to get it from Amazon, I've got the sizes of those screws you're going to need. We do get nylon ones in this. And you're going to see that part of the pack. But today we're going to be starting to finish the panels and then installing some of the electrics. And from here on out, we're actually building the working parts of the droid. So this is going to be absolutely brilliant. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link down here to the Fanhome website. You can get this all the way from pack one. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So this is the dome. This is what we've been working on so far. And so far, we've just been putting all of these sections in here, as you can see, with double-sided tape. So we are going to be putting a few more just into this section here. So let me show you the magazine. This is what that's looking like here. You see, we've got some more dome fittings here. Now, we do have some spacers. We don't need these until stage 64, so we need to keep them safe. But as you can see, once again, we're going to be putting some double-sided tape in here, putting the last of the two panels in, which means there's one panel left. That's going to be a hinged panel, which we're going to see in the next stage. And then we've just got the top of the dome to create here and put into place. So we've got everything here. As I said, this is what we need to keep safe. Just put that to one side. Open this pack up, and I'm interested first off just in these adhesive strips. Now, if you remember the last stage, similar to what we've done here, I'm just going to take these strips here and I'm going to be putting these into place. Now, the panel next to this one here doesn't have a plate, so we won't be putting any adhesive on this one. It's just going to be on these two panels here. So there we go, put them in. Just get some tweezers and peel the backing off these. Just one more to take off here. And just to remind you that this is only a temporary thing. These panels aren't actually attached with this stickiness here. This is just to keep them in place before we put it on the actual frame section. So these are the panels. Let's just put these into place. Remember, we're missing this one here. So it's going to go one in here, kind of like that. One in this side. I'm just going to turn it over and line it up. So there you go. As you can see, they're all in, no problems at all. We're then just going to be taking this lovely detailed silver ring here with the blue top. And we have got a little detail just to put into this side, push that in, make sure it's all lined up. Perfect. So that's fitting nice and flush in there. And then this is going to go on top of this section just here. Make sure the panels underneath that we've just put in are through these sections. That'll just help to keep everything lined up here. There we go, as you can see, so they're all through that section there, and that's all there is to do in that stage. So this is where things are going to get really busy, because we need to get together everything that we've been working on that's culminated in this point right here, issue 64. We do have a lot of parts in here, and this is going to have a panel with the hinge. I believe we saved the hinge at the start of this build. We're not going to need the hinge we saved because it comes in this one, as you can see here. We do need the foam base because we're going to be turning the R2-D2 head over and putting it into the foam base there. And then we're going to be starting to fit the panel into place on the frame, put the spacers in. We're going to be putting some of the lenses in for the hologram. We're going to be connecting all of the top section up and screwing that in. These are the plastic little fittings that are going to hold the plates into place, but I'm going to be using metal ones for this. As you can see, they started to put them in here. Then we're going to be putting the lenses in. I mean, there's absolutely loads to do. Check this out, look. So when we get to this point, it's going to look quite impressive. So the first thing we're going to do is going to take the panel and we're going to be putting this into the hinge just like that there. And that's going to be held in with one of the long screws that we've got in this stage, which look just like that. It's going to go in this side. Get that all the way through. And it will come out the other side. We don't want to over tighten this. So just hand tight, because we want to be able to have this freely come up and drop down just like that. Oops, I'm dropping it. So up and down. Now we're going to be bringing up the frame section that we've been working on in the R2 throughout this build so far. And this is going to go just on the point that you can see here. You see you've got three holes. The middle hole here is for that lug that we've got just there in the hinge we put in. So this is actually going to go in kind of like, oops, get it in, that there. It's going to be held in with some silver screws. They're the 2.5 by 4 mil screws. So I've got one of them here. That's the first one in. Just put that in loose till I got the second one in. There you go. There's the second one. And then make sure that hinge is nice and tight. And then it's free to close and open just like that. So now we're going to need the spacers that we had from the last stage. Just get these off. And I'm just going to get a sprue cutter just to cut these off of this. We don't need these straight away, but we will have these later on. And the first thing we want is, I'm guessing this is a little microphone here. So this is going to be going into the hole that we can just see there. Thread this through. Now this came in, let me try and think. I think it was issue 3. So it's one of the first things that we had. It's going to go in here just like that. And when we've lined it up kind of like where it's going to go, we're actually going to be putting the frame on top. So here's the frame. Just get everything lined up here. I'm going to hold the microphone while I put this down. Don't want to pinch any wires. So there you go, that's in just like that. Now this top disc that we had in before, we can now take that off because the frame is actually holding all of these panels in now. And the reason we've taken it off is because one of these little lugs here is shorter than the rest of them. And it's this one here, it's actually got an arrow pointing towards it. We want to make sure that that one goes into this one just here. So if this is the long section here, we want it to go in that one there. Now I'm going to flip the whole assembly upside down. And you remember those spacers we cut off? Now's the time to put them in. So I'm just going to put this wire out the way for a second. Thread it through there, actually. So you can kind of see what I'm doing. And just push these spacers in. So there's five of these. We don't put one in the short one that we just lined up. 2, 3. Four. And finally, 5. So they're all in. And then we've got these 6 mil flange screws here, and this is what's going to actually hold that in. So I'll get one in, just that's going to hold everything into place. Perfect. So I can now gently put that down. And we're going to be putting these 6 mil screws into all of the, you can probably see it on that camera there, onto all of these lifters except for the small one. Now the small one there, I'll put that in, does have, as you can probably expect, a smaller flange screw. And that came in this pack as well. So I'll get that small one in now and just finish off doing the large 6 mil flange screws. So now the metal dome and the frame are now married together. So before we continue, I just want to turn this upside down and check that this hinge flap can come up. And as you can see, no problems at all with that. So that's perfect. And this is where it wants me to take a sprue cutter, cut off some of these plastic hex screws here, which look like this. And these are going to attach in the inside of the dome. So, going to have me little tweezers, a pointing device. The first place it wants me to put one is just in this hinge position, just here. But I'm not going to be using these little plastic threaded ones. I'm going to be using the metal ones. Now, you will notice the biggest difference between using these metal ones and the other ones that we come with it is that these are longer. So they're going to push out the panels a lot firmer than the plastic ones will. But I'm just going to get one of these in and show you what that looks like. And there we go. That's in place. Now, as you see, that is flush now to that panel, that first one I put in. If we just have a look at these plastic ones here and look at the difference in length, that means that when those plastic ones went in, there's a good like millimeter, I'd say, of gap between that and the plate. And I think that's the reason that I went with these metal ones in the end, but they are on my Amazon store. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to put some more into position. And basically, I'm going to be doing 1, 2, 3, 4, then jumping over to this side, 5, 6. And that will be all complete. So that's 6 in place, just like that, which means now these two panels are securely in place. So I'm going to be putting the components in now. The first component I've got is the lens. I believe this came in stage 1, and we want to have this side here, which has got the two little things for a digital display here. We want the small hole next to it. Get this notch and just align it with the notch on the side of the frame so that sits in just like that. So the first component that's going behind that is this lens here. Be careful, there are two similar lenses. We've got this one and we've got this one. There is a difference between them. Just look at how the indents on these are different. We want this one here. That's going to go over the top of that lens, lining that up this way round. Excellent. And that's held in with one of the black 6mm screws. As a matter of fact, two of the black 6mm screws. And there you go. That's perfect and that's in place. Now we need this component, and I think you pretty much guess where this is going. So with this lead here, closest to the lead that we put in there, which means it's going in this way, this is just going to go into this position just here. So line it up. Look how it looks from the other side. Perfect. Make sure it goes through, you see, so it's flush. And once again, we're going to be putting those in with the same self-tapping black screws. Now, this is a tight fit in here, just so you know. So if it's not going in all the way, make sure you push it really hard in here until you hear a click. Now, I have put the air conditioning on, so if it's sounding a bit different, that's why. But there we go. That's in place like that. Lovely and flush, as you can see there. Another logic circuit to put in now, which looks like that. That's going to go onto this long panel that we can just see there. It's going to go this way round with this section here pointing towards the inside of the dome. So when we've got this on, it's going to line it up. It's going to look like that from this side, and it's actually going to be screwed into the frame from these points here. And these are going to be the 4mm silver screws like this. So that's 1 and 2. Perfect. Now we're going to be putting this detail in. If you remember this one, I think this came in stage 9. We want to put it in with this tab facing the top here. So when we put it in, it's going to go in like this. Put that into position. There is sort of like a recess for that tab to sit in. Just like that there. I'm just making sure this is completely in, like that. And this is held in, again, with the black self-tapping screws. And there you go, that's in. If you're having problems getting that in, just flip that round, because there are a slight difference between the lengths between each point there. But that looks like that there. And that is all there is to do in stage 64. Now in stage 65, just flick through, once again there's lots and lots of little details we're going to start attaching to the dome. We've got that other lens there to put in. We are going to now put this on the foam base that we saved from last time. Putting all this together, looks like we've got a little bit of glue just to put a few more details in there. So by the end of it, it's going to look just like that. So I've got the foam dome here and I've just put that over just like this. I've also zoomed out some of the cameras here. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start attaching some more of these little metal things that we've been putting in. This time we're just going to the left of what we've just done there, and I'm going to be putting two into these positions here first. And then I'm going to continue so that all six of these will be in place. And there you go, that's the other six in place. Okay, we're going to need another lens now. That is this one, and I believe we had this from stage 45, but the lens for this actually comes in this stage. And that looks just like this. So if I just tilt this over a second, this is going to go with the notch facing up into the hole that we've got left that this is going to fit in. So just like that there. And then we're going to be putting this lens over the top of it. Now when we put the lens in, we want the wire to be facing nearest to the rim of the dome. So this is just going to go in like that. Once again, held in with the black self-tapping screws. Very hard to film this, but you get the idea. Let's put that to one side, because now we're going to be just building up the projector parts now. So we need this part. We need the rim that's going over the top like that, and also the base here. So we want this notch at the bottom just here to be in the opposite direction to this tab at the top. Probably best on the top camera. We'll zoom up a little bit actually so you can see this. So it's like that. That notch there in the opposite direction to that there. Excellent. The reason we're doing that is because we're going to be now taking this section from the base and putting the tab here just into that notch. Like that. So now that's in position like that. Now holding all of this together, bring over the dome again. This is going to go into the hole that we've just got here, with the top of this tab, whoops, folded over, facing upwards towards the lip of the R2. So let me just get this in and show you how this looks. Perfect, just like that. Once again, that's held in with the black self-tapping screws. That is perfect. So there you go. That's in just like that. So I'm just going to turn the dome over. And if you look at this side here, we've got these two small holes. Now we've got these little sections here to go into those, but they are going to need to be glued in to hold themselves into place. I'm just going to check actually if we can get away without gluing these. I don't think we're going to be able to. Oh, actually, I don't know actually. Might have gone in really stiff. So as you can see, they're not coming out. So I'm not actually going to glue mine in. Again, bring up my foam to protect this. So we've got this here. And I've got these cable clips here to put into place. So the first one is going to go where this blue lens was here, with the clip facing towards that blue lens. It's just going to go in there like that. It's held in with one of the small 2.5 by 4 mil silver screws there. And the second and third are just going into the positions. If I put them in, might be best to actually just show you that. Again, with the open end of the clip facing towards the edge of the dome. I'll get these two in. So now all three clips, as you can see, are in like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. that just brings us on to the last stage here, which is stage 66. And as you can see, we've got our first circuit board here. And obviously we've got some more screws. So by the look of it, we're going to be putting some more screws into place. We're taking the holographic imager. We're going to be mounting that in. That's going to project Luke and Leia's hologram. And then we're going to be attaching the circuit board into the dome. So just like what we've been doing, we are going to be working anti-clockwise and putting another 6 screws in. So I'm actually putting 2 just in this side next to that logic board there. So that's those 2 in. And then we're just going to go back to where we were before. And we're just going to extend out the plates that we've already done. So it's these 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, just by the round hole there. So there you go. They're in. I will have a count up at the end just to let you know how many of those screws that we actually need. Now I need the projector. So this is what the projector looks like. And that's just going to be going on top here into the projector case. And it's going to be secured into these points just here and here. It's actually going to be secured in once again with the black 2.3x6mm screws. So that's the projector in. Again, put that to one side, bring out the control board that came with this stage here. Obviously I don't need the screws, I'm not using those. And I'm going to mount the control board into this case this way around, just like that there. And that's held in once again with the black self-tapping screws. 1, 2, and 3. And this is just going to go next to the holographic projector, just into that position there with the small silver screws. And finally, number 3. And that massive pack is all there is to do. And that's completed that pack. There was loads to do in that, but as you see, it's really coming along. This has got some weight to it now. But that is what the dome is looking like. And that is what the inside's looking like. So we are getting there with that. I'm so glad that we kept all of the packaging materials for that. So obviously it makes it easier to work with. But if you want to get this for yourself, once again, I have put the link down here to the Fanhome website. You can get that all the way from pack 1. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.